Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Beloved, welcome you to this exciting edition of the Voice of Resurrection devotional and this mystery on the miracle offering. We talked about Cornelius and the testimony he had, and we want to look at that mystery today because we understood from Philippians 4 that our account is the mention of our name in the presence of God. And his story, his experiences, his devotion, his faithfulness is a great example for all of us to follow. Acts chapter 10, the Bible says there was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band, a devout man, and one that feared God with all his house, which gave, listen carefully, much alms to the people and prayed to God always. This is not a broke intercessor. This is a man, he said he prayed always and he gave. He was a giver. He was a seed sower. He was a philanthropist. He was a charitable man. But the amazing thing is Cornelius wasn't even a Jew. He is a centurion, a Roman centurion. And his order is the Italian band. But he was a devout man. He came through Rome to Israel. And he embraced the God of Abraham. See? He feared God. A devout man, and he loved the Lord and feared him with all his house. He was a man that I believe had family altar, led devotions in his house, commanded. He wasn't engaging in the Roman debauchery and all the craziness going on. This man was consecrated and dedicated to the Lord. Watch this. And he prayed to God always. Verse 3, he saw in a vision, evidently about the ninth hour. You notice what it takes to see authentic visions? Consecration, dedication, faithfulness, lots and lots of prayer. I so resent this thing in this generation where people are running around with offering for people to prophesy to them and will not spend time to develop themselves before the Lord. And they're going to live and die in spiritual poverty, not knowing the Lord. And these enablers don't even understand what's going on. I refuse to join that crowd. I teach that every believer should fight to get into the presence of God. Sow a seed for the realms of the Spirit to open to you, but not for me to be a surrogate. Of course, everybody needs a help when you are stuck on your path. Yes, then we come and cheer you on and help you. But you must press your way into the very presence of God yourself and be blessed by your God and be fathered by your Father. He is the Father of spirits. He needs to father rejection out of you, father imbecility out of you, father that orphan spirit out of you, so you will be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. When was the last time you saw a vision, beloved? Isn't it something that even Jews themselves were there and didn't even have such encounters with God? And yet Cornelius pressed his way through. He saw in a vision, evidently about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid. Of course, never seen any such thing. And said, what is it, Lord? You can see he knew the Lord in that sense. And he said unto him, listen carefully, thy prayers and thine alms come up for a memorial before God. Wow! Your prayers and your gifts, your seed, your philanthropy, your humanitarian help has not only been mentioned in the presence of God, but it became a memorial, a permanent fixture in the presence of God. You are before the Lord day and night. You are constantly sowing, giving, helping, praying, interceding until you were a daily mention before God, until you became a fixture. Wow. This is a rich man. Rich in God. His account was abounding. Wow. And his devotion, his seed, his prayers, his consecration, so moved God that God said, okay, I'm going to make you one of my sons. Hallelujah. And the word of the Lord came to him in the vision. The angel said, your prayers and your alms are come. I don't even need to go any further for today. Your prayers and your alms are come up for a memorial before God. How do you rate, beloved? How has your prayers done? What about your giving? Has it cost God to send an angelic detail? Has it caused God to cause miracles to begin to move? The whole thing is all about doing what God wants. You see, the way I got my covenant that I will never have lack in my life again. In those days of $300 a month, I told the testimony how I was going to the main post office here in Atlanta. And this Caucasian woman, young, nice-looking woman, well-dressed, you know, jeans and white blouse, came up to me asking with a sign for help. And of course, I felt it was fake. And God said, don't judge. Give. So I took out my little money and I was looking for $1 or something. God said, no, give her the highest denomination you have. Wow. And then it was a 20. And I gave it to the woman in obedience to God. And the woman said, God bless you. And when she made that pronouncement, I felt God from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. It was like, oh, just washed through me. I was stunned. I don't even know if that was an angel. And I drove off. And I hadn't quite turned into the road when God swore to me. He said, because you obeyed me, you will never be hungry again in this life. Wow. I got my covenant. That's the way this kingdom, oh, gotta go. That's the way this kingdom is run. The moment God is pleased, the moment your offering moves heaven, you got it made. No power can stop anything. I gotta go. What can I do? I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye. Yes, he is.